Practicing peripheral nerve blocks entails a great deal of decision-making. However hard we try to standardize peripheral nerve block techniques, anatomy always throws a wrench, and there's always anatomical variations that require us to actively engage into decision-making during each and every nerve block performance. So let's demonstrate that in an axillary brachial plexus block. So the axillary brachial plexus block is performed by injecting local anesthetic inside a sheath that contains the axillary brachial plexus. And that sheath surrounds also the axillary artery and axillary veins, as well as ulnar nerve, radial nerve, and median nerve. The musculocutaneous nerve is always outside, or most of the time. And depending on the location of these veins, we may have to change an approach or which block we first perform. So let's dig a little bit deeper into the NYSORA's compendium of regional anesthesia. Axillary brachial plexus block is an extremely useful technique, and it's a first choice in our practice for anything on the hand and even on the elbow surgery, if you will. But when we talk about axillary brachial plexus block, our standardized teaching is you don't have to chase separate nerves. You do not have to separately inject for median nerve, ulnar nerve, radial nerve. Rather, what we try to accomplish is inject local anesthetic inside the sheath that contains all of these nerves. However, which injection occurs first depends on the location of the veins inside the axillary brachial plexus sheath. So, as an example, a standardized approach that we use routinely about 80% of the time is an injection of the local anesthetic posterior to the artery and injection of the local anesthetic superior to the artery. So now we're talking about 8 milliliters behind the artery, 8 milliliters above the artery, and the remaining 4 milliliters out of a 20 milliliter syringe, which is the maximum we would ever use for axillary brachial plexus, occurs over here for the musculocutaneous nerve in the fascia between the biceps and coracobrachialis. But now we're going to go to the real clinical case, and we will see how that is not always so easy, as the location and the size of the axillary vein may dictate which injection and where we inject first. Okay, so we have a patient scheduled for tendon release of the thumb, and we're going to do an axillary brachial plexus block for this operation. So as we look at the ultrasound image, what we can see here is that's the humerus, that's the conjoint tendon, and that's the axillary brachial plexus sheath, okay? So the first thing that we want to focus on is what is actually the strategy to accomplish this block. Well, let's first do a couple of maneuvers. We're going to press and depress on the ultrasound probe, and pressing and depressing on the ultrasound probe will help us determine the presence of the vessels that we need to be concerned about. So in here, what we see is there's a very large axillary vein. That's the axillary artery, which is the main internal landmark. And underneath the axillary artery, we also have a couple of veins above the artery and below the artery. So let's just tweak up our gain a little bit. And here we can see now the median nerve attached to the artery. That's the ulnar nerve above the artery. And in here, underneath the artery, is the radial nerve sitting right on the conjoint tendon. Now, so we have several different options. The first option would be to pass a needle to block the median nerve, then the ulnar nerve, and then advance to get the radial nerve. That's one option. Ideally, with each and every axillary block, we would like to fill this space with the local anesthetic and not worry about blocking specific separate nerves. But in this particular situation, may or may not be possible. Let's focus also to see where the musculocutaneous nerve is, and there it is. Musculocutaneous nerve run between the biceps femoris muscle and coracobrachialis muscle, and it's quite clear that we're going to need to block that separately. Okay, so this is the block strategy. We're going to pass a needle in plane technique just above the axillary artery to place it at about 12 or 11 o'clock position, and inject 8 milliliters of local anesthetic, and then we'll make decisions based on what spread of the local anesthetic we get then. So now we can see the needle entering through the superficial fascia. We're now in the biceps muscle, and if you see, we're getting pulsations of the muscle because we are using a nerve stimulator that is connected to the needle with a current of 0.5 milliamps as a monitoring tool. And these local twitches inside biceps simply tell us that we're not in the position where we want to be. You see, it gives us a position of the needle just in case we did not see it, which we do in this example. So we continue with the needle just above the axillary artery, and we push the artery so the artery gets actually distorted as the needle enters into the sheath of the axillary plexus. Okay, so we're going to slack off the pressure one more time. That's good. All right, aspiration is negative and the twitch is absent, which is what we want. And we inject. So we can see the first injection that we are making, it actually results in a quite substantial spread of the local anesthetic inside the fascia. So we're injecting 4 milliliters, we're injecting 5 milliliters, we're not going to move the needle anywhere during this injection. 6 milliliters, 7 milliliters, 8 milliliters. Okay, so now what we've done is really injected local anesthetic above the axillary artery, and the local anesthetic spread to block the median nerve and the ulnar nerve as well. Now, I don't believe that we have succeeded in blocking the radial nerve, so we're going to direct the needle down and advance the needle towards the radial nerve. In case our needle gets anywhere close to the radial nerve, we might get a motor stimulation. So let's just avoid the entrance of the needle into the axillary artery. Yes, that's good, push. I'm sorry, axillary vein, push. One more time, push, push. Okay, so let's see. Here we have actually a twitch. Okay, so that allowed us to pull the needle back, because if we did not get that twitch, we actually wouldn't know that we are on the one aspect of the radial nerve, which is over here. So that allows us to stop. And again, one good example of why using nerve stimulation is useful as a monitoring tool, not the nerve localization tool. So we go back to our injection method, which is?
Wrap.
So what we have, R is for response to nerve stimulation is now absent. A, aspiration to detect blood is negative. And pressure on injection of the local anesthetic is normal. So let's see the spread of the local anesthetic. And now we can see how the local anesthetic basically spreads around the radial nerve, which avoided the need for us to do multiple injections around each and every nerve. Okay, so now once we're in this position, what we want to do is pull the needle back to the median nerve, and we will inject another 1 or 2 milliliters of local anesthetic to reinforce the median nerve right there. We want to definitely stay inside the axillary brachial plexus sheath, and that means very close to the artery, and that's the median nerve. Okay, so let's do that injection. Again, wrap maneuver, response is absent, aspiration negative, pressure is less than 15 psi, pull back a little bit more, pull back a little bit more. The next thing we want to do, we can see how the median nerve is attached with the fascia to the musculocutaneous nerve. So we're going to use this opportunity to pull the needle back, insert it into that fascia of the musculocutaneous nerve that connects to the median nerve, and inject local anesthetic into the fascia layer. A little steeper, push. One more time, push. That's it. So we went through the fascia, we pulled back. Again, we look for the response. It's absent. As a safety measure, we document this. Aspiration is negative, and injection of the local anesthetic has no pressure, and we can see how the local anesthetic is spreading, and now we're going to complete that injection. Pull back a little bit, pull back a little bit, pull back a little. Now we can see the spread of the local anesthetic around the musculocutaneous nerve as well as the median nerve as well. 1, 2, 3 injection, and that was it. That was the decision making during an atypical axillary brachial plexus block performance. And as we discussed, axillary brachial plexus has so many variations. And depending on the location of the large vessels inside the axillary brachial plexus sheath, we make decisions which injection do we perform first, above or below the artery, and the progression of the block as to planning where the injections will take place. If you like NYSORA channel, do subscribe and never miss the beat. See you next time.